we'll start out with the testimony, and I got just a short little thing here I want to share with you. And how many feel like you received a miracle tonight? You came up here and you felt like, amen, amen. And the Lord dealt with me a few back in before Brother Terry's conference. My son, and actually both my sons, had COVID, and Matt and Alana and the girls got through it at home. But my son Seth got it. And a couple of days later, he wound up having to go to the hospital. And some of y'all, you've heard this, but I want to lay a foundation for what I want to say here. Because, anyhow, I want to get ahead of myself. But Seth texted me, he couldn't talk, he had the air and stuff, and the doctor told him not to be talking. So he's texting. And he said, Dad, they're telling me, and he'd been there about 4 or 5 days then. He said, Dad, they're telling me I'm going to be here 6 to 10 weeks. I said, please pray. But I'd already been up to the hospital one time and just sat in the parking lot and prayed. And then after he texted me, Cheryl and I went up there. And we got out. There was a sidewalk all the way around that hospital. So we walked around that hospital praying in the spirit, praying and believing God. And I said, God, they're saying, and you know, of course, you're a dad. And all of a sudden, you know, you hear about, they mentioned ventilators and all this stuff, you know. And so I'm talking about somebody I changed his diaper. He's 42 years old now, but he's... So the intercession was so intense and so deep. There's other people we're praying for at the same time. But the Lord spoke to me and said, you're not dealing with COVID. I said, what? The Lord said, you're dealing with the spirit of COVID.
Right.
I'm going to show you that in a minute. And I'm going to try to... Cheryl fusses when I get to moving too fast or reading too fast, so I'm going to try to take my time, but yet be quick, okay? And so we got to Brother Terry's conference. And so 2 days later, after the doctor had already told him 6 to 10 weeks, 2 days later at 9 o'clock at night, there had been two people come in there, and Cheryl and I had prayed when we was walking in up. Hospital, God, somebody can help get Seth where he needs to be to get out of the hospital. And two people came in there and just supernaturally were moved on to do what needed to be done, and they began to process him. He has this, had pneumonia and his lungs full, and anyhow, they wound up giving him a shot. And forgive my gravity, but he said, Dad. He said, I peed it all out. And in other words, it started to process that all that fluid just went out of his body. And 2 days later, they never let you out at 9 o'clock at night, but they let him out of a Sunday service in South Carolina at Brother Terry's, and got the text, Dad, I'm going home. They're sending me home right now.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Erica began to text, his wife began to text, and anyhow, he's back at work now. Everything's moving forward. Still got a little shortness of breath now and then, but he's processed on through that, and God did it. And I had to go back and said, okay, God, and other people, there was others that we prayed sincerely for at the same time. 2-3 other ministers that didn't make it. Another young man that his same age was in the hospital, that his kidneys had started failing because of the medications they were giving. Doing all, I mean, he come so close to dine, and we kept praying at the same time. And I got word he's home. They had to give him some speech therapy. His kidneys are working again. Everything, the process going forward. But yet, I don't know. I don't understand all the other things, but I do understand and know what God told me. God said to me, you've got to deal with the spirit of COVID. And he went on to say and said, there is no sickness. COVID, cancer, come on, pneumonia, there's no diabetes, there's no, and somebody's, I know I'm setting myself up for some criticism here, but God said there's no sickness that I haven't already paid the price for.
Yes, praise God.
When he took stripes upon his back, every sickness, every disease, and COVID was no surprise to God.
Right.
So by the stripes of Jesus Christ, COVID has already been, if it hadn't been, Bud Ridner wouldn't be sitting here tonight. But because he knew in his spirit, he knew and had that relationship with God, that faith in that, and because he knew, I believe, but because he knew how to deal with the spiritual thing more than just the sickness, come on, and see, and God took me to a scripture, a couple of things. First of all, in Luke 10:19, and I'm just going to kind of breeze over this, but he said, behold, I give you power over all the power of the enemy. Okay? And Mark 16:17, I think it says something like, I give you power over serpents and scorpions. That's demon spirits, y'all. I don't mean go out and handle snakes and scorpions and stuff. But I give you power over those spirits. But in Luke, the 13th chapter, and I'm going to cut some of the scripture here. I've got so I can get to the point. Well, let me go ahead. Verse 14. And the ruler of the synagogue answered with indignation, calls that Jesus, and I'm in the right place. Hold on. No. It's Luke 13, verse 11. That's wrong side. And behold, there was a woman which hath a spirit. Somebody say spirit.
Spirit.
Now, this is important because I've seen it happen before whenever God would heal somebody. When people got miracles, just like happened here tonight, that the spirit of unbelief tries to come back to us and tries to rob us, come on, of what God did. Can somebody hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
See, that's why Jesus would say, go and sin no more, lest the worst thing come upon you. He said that to me whenever the doctor told me, give me a bad report. And I prayed and said, God, will you heal me of this? And he said, yes, if you'll go and sin no more. I won't go into a detail on the details on that, but it's a good testimony to y'all. And behold, there was a woman which had the spirit of infirmity 18 years and was bowed down. I'm not going to do the numerology and all this thing. And was bowed together. What bowed her together? The spirit of infirmity. Can somebody hear what I'm saying? That no doubt she was something in her kept desiring for God to heal her, but there was a spirit that had to be dealt with, had bound her together, and could in no wise lift herself up. Can you hear what I'm saying? Now see, here the way the enemy works, I know the mic's there, the way the enemy works is he as long as he can keep us bowed over looking into the dust realm.
Yes.
We can't see the answer as long as we look or looking into the dust realm. But whenever we can straighten up, come on, look at somebody and say, straighten up.
Straighten up.
Hallelujah. And see, God has given us authority. God's already taken care of sickness and disease. Can you hear me? He's already healed. Come on. The finished work was not only for your salvation, it was for your healing.
Amen.
It's already finished.
Hallelujah.
Come on. Jews saw her, he called unto him and said unto her, Woman, thou art loosed from thine infirmity.
Amen.
And I want to declare today that God has already given us authority. The place we have to step into now.
Yeah.
Come on, we receive the healing of God. We receive what He's already done. He's already healed us by His stripes. But the spirit of that, the reason He gave us the power over those spirits is now whenever the spirit of the thing comes at us.
Amen.
I sit back there and rejoice whenever I hear that God brought somebody through brain cancer, because I've had a loved one. I sat in a chair beside Gail for over a year with brain cancer, praying, and I rejoiced because I was trying to deal with the sickness all the time. 1 year and one day after she was diagnosed with two surgeries, she went on to be with the Lord. And I said, God, I hate cancer. And God said, I'm going to show you how to deal with it. And I quit dealing with the sickness because Jesus already dealt with the sickness. Now I deal with the spirit of the thing. Come on, those of you that come up and you got your miracle tonight, you got a touch from God, let me tell you something. The spirit of the thing is apt to come back, but I want to declare unto you tonight that you have authority over that spirit. Do not let the spirit of the thing bow you to the ground anymore. Hallelujah. It caused you to keep looking in the dust rim. Hallelujah. Straighten yourself up and say, wait a minute. I know the touch God gave for me. Eddie knew whenever his back was touched and he got out of the bed. Somebody love the Lord.
Yeah.
Come on, thank God he didn't listen to his dad so much that night that was panicking and said, wait a minute, don't make sense in my head. You need to be in the bed. But come on, somebody hear what I'm saying. Nothing wrong with laying down in the bed, though, and resting. But let me tell you something. The spirit of infirmity, many times sickness starts with the spirit of infirmity.
Yes.
I'm not going to read anymore because I feel like I'm about done what God wants me to do. A lot of times sickness begins with the spirit of infirmity. It begins with something inside. It's dis-ease.
Yeah.
Come on. There's something wrong with your ease. The enemy is taking your peace. But if your peace can remain,
yes.
Hallelujah, God can take you through anything. Look at somebody say he's going to take you through anything.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So today I want to declare unto you that God has dealt with the spirit of infirmity, and God wants us as the church to straighten up, to stand up. Come on, somebody hear what I'm saying.
Yes.
Let me take it a step further. What's the spirit on this nation right now? It's a spirit of infirmity. It's a spirit that keeps us bowing down as a nation and looking into the dust rim. But can I tell you something today? If we can straighten ourselves up, hallelujah, and as the church, it's got to begin with the church. Hallelujah, and if the church will get rid of that infirm spirit and say, wait a minute, hallelujah, I'm part of the kingdom of God, and I'm straightening myself up.
Yeah.
Hallelujah, God's given me authority over all the authority of the enemy and the gates of hell will not prevail against us. And if we'll stand up, can I tell you, it will permeate through this nation. What made this nation great wasn't great politics. Hallelujah, it wasn't some great man. Hallelujah, it was the fact that somebody called on the name of the Lord. And it goes all the way back to the founders of our nation. Didn't stop there. Hallelujah. What's made the races and the civil rights movement great was a man like Martin Luther King Jr. that prayed. Hallelujah. And come on, that didn't get out there and show us how to show everybody how to protest and all that. He showed them how to walk in peace.
Yes, praise
God. Somebody hear what I'm saying? So now we have our chance. Spirit of infirmity, I'm loosed.
Amen. Amen.
I want to tell you something. That spirit trying to come against my mind while my son was laying in the hospital.
That's right.
That spirit kept trying to come against me and, And I'm seeing other people fail, and I'm saying, no, God, I'm not going to give into this spirit of infirmity. I'm going to stand on the word of God. Come on, and I don't care if it's COVID, cancer. Thank God that Christy stood against that spirit, and she received the prayers of the saints, and we begin to agree together. Thank God for that. Thank God for the grace and mercy we saw on this whole family during that time. And God's not through, hallelujah, but, and they're not going to bow, and we're not going to bow, hallelujah. And when that spirit tries to come back to any one of us, especially those that came up here for a touch tonight, hallelujah, I want to tell you something. I receive the hand of God that's laid upon us. And come on, stand up with me real quick. I'm getting ready to sit down. Hallelujah. And I want you to lift your hands and say, I'm free of the spirit of infirmity. Yeah.